Hello all, Onivox here. With the Helipal.com and Storm Racing drones, Lumineer QAV210 Charpu Storm Edition RTF Race Drone. Thank you to them for putting together such an awesome RTF package. Let's take a closer look. First off, the frame is a Lumineer QAV210. What makes it special is it is designed for and named after the godfather of freestyle Charpu. Being a 210 Charpu edition, the center fuselage is actually a 180 size, so it's going to be a little bit narrower. And the arms are actually stretched to accommodate 5-inch props. As you can see, they just barely make it. At the front, we have a Foxeer 600 TV LCCD camera. It comes stock with a 2.8mm lens. It is the locking ring style, making for quick focus adjustments or lens changes. In the middle is the Team Black Sheep power cube. On the bottom it has the power distribution board. In the middle are four bulletproof 30 amp ESCs. At the top is the Calibri Race Edition F3 flight controller running clean flight. Behind that is the receiver. It is a RadioLink R9D 9 channel S-Bus compatible receiver. It has a BODA or boosted omnidirectional antenna. That's what this little dongle is. Above that is the VTX. It is a Storm 600 milliwatt 32 channel VTX with race band. It is RPSMA connection style. On the end of the arms, we have the Storm Race Edition 2204 Pro 2300 kV motors. They're very pretty. The red windings inside, I really like that. Also get very good prop bite with the design of the top of the motors. Also at the back we can see the LED light strip. It has three light modes, green for disarm, blue for arm, and red for low battery. Comes with the foam battery pad, battery strap, and action cam mounts. It is very pretty. The controller is an AT9. It's very comfortable. I have no problem with it. I'm a thumb flyer and it's very comfortable for me. On the left shoulder you have slow, medium, and fast. And on the right side we have angle, horizon, and acro flight modes. Very comfortable controller. Very nice display. As you can see, I made mine say Animus Vox, and if you look right here, you can see as I change it, it'll tell you whether or not you're in active or stabilized flight modes. And that's it out of the box. Thank you to Helipal and Storm Racing Drones again for putting together such an awesome RTF racing drone. Now let's talk about some of the modifications I've done. First, as you can see, I put these motor guards on here. I got these from flightclub.com. They come with the black hardware. Very easy to change. I also purchased their front skid plate. Also comes with the hardware. In the back, I purchased their receiver and VTX holders. They fit perfectly. Back, I have replaced the stock antenna with a Team Black Sheep Triumph antenna. It is RPSMA, so I didn't need an adapter. I switched out the stock XT60 connector for a black one. I swapped out the stock silver 35mm standoffs for these red ones. And I changed all the hardware out for this black hardware. I just thought it looked better. have my own antenna mount here, which I secured with fishing line. I secure most of my connections with 20 pound fishing line. I like it better than zip ties. I think it looks a little cleaner. You can see more right here through the top back here. On the bottom, I removed the factory landing legs and replaced them with these nice Lumineer spongy landing feet. I saw a video from Lumineer where they talk about where the landing legs could get snagged on things or even torn off. So they made these neoprene landing feet, and I decided good idea to go ahead and pick some up. Also, while we're looking at the bottom, I heat shrunk and fishing line secured down the motor wires. From the factory, they come with just a zip tie across there. I obviously didn't like that from the top. I think it looks a lot better with just the fishing line. So yeah, secured those down nice and snug. Not going to do any damage to them. I also got these nice red Mr. Steel HQ prop 5x4x3 props from getpropsman.com. And I swapped out the factory prop nuts for these Lumineer low profile 5M prop nuts. Well, that's it for modifications. I think it's very pretty. Obviously going with a red and black motif. Thank you again to Propsman, Lumineer, Helipal.com, Storm Racing Drones, and Flight Club for helping me put together such a, in my opinion, sweet little race drone. Thanks for watching, all. Cheers. Godspeed.